Hey guys, here Mark the Geek, and this video I want to share with you guys the new latest update for the PlayStation Vita, which is System Update version 3.30. With this update, these are the things that we're going to get. Now we got in the settings, we're going to have a theme and background. It says has been added to settings. You can now download your favorite themes and customize your PlayStation Vita and your PS TV. Over here says you can now check the rarity of the trophies. That's a thing that you could do before on the PlayStation 4. You can also now attach and send events created in calendar to messages and emails. Recipients can now save those events into their own calendars. Also, you can now add friends and other players to events created in calendar. And there's a couple updates that are coming to the PlayStation Vita TV, which is now is going to be PS TV for United States. Right now it says the name of the VTE 1000 series has been changed to PlayStation TV. Now I guess that's the version that came out for Japan, which has that number VTE 1000, if I'm not mistaken. So now it's officially going to be changed to PlayStation TV. That's very good to know. Also, here it says that a maximum of 4 wireless controllers can be connected to the PlayStation TV. The number of players, of course, is going to depend on the game or applications that you're using. That is very cool that with this update, we actually see some things that is coming to the PS TV very, very soon. So first of all, let's go ahead and show you guys one update here that has been added, which is the trophy. Okay, so when you're here in the trophy section, when you tap on one of the trophies, let's go ahead and tap right there. Now you're gonna see right here it has like a little, that has like 4 dots. One dot means that's a common trophy, and like you see here, 2 dots, if you click right there, now you're gonna see the rare percentage, 44.1. And it has 2 dots. That's the only difference right now here in the trophies. If you go back here to the PlayStation tab right there, and you click there, like you see, you're not gonna see the rarity of the trophies. Like you see there, you won't see it at all. You only see it when you tap here on the PSN tab. Let's go ahead and show you guys another one. Let's go ahead and Infamous First Light. We go here, and like you see there, you're gonna see the rarity of the trophies right there. You click there, it says very rare, and that's it. Basically, that's the only difference when it comes to the trophies. Okay, so here in calendar, let's go ahead and open calendar so you guys can see the changes here. What it means when it says that you can actually now share your events is, like, for example, right here I have a couple events there in my calendar, like you see there, very cool. Let's say I want to share this event right here. It says PlayStation TV release, which is October 14. If I click on it, like you see there, you're going to see some information whatsoever. You click there. Now you have the options to send it using a message or send it by email. I'm going to go ahead here and send it by message. So for the purpose of this video, I'm just going to share my events with anybody here with my friends here. Let's go ahead and choose randomly people here. Let's go ahead and choose a couple. So like you see here, you just go ahead and choose a lot of people, whoever you want to send it to. Right now, I'm just going to go ahead and spam everybody here with my event. And when I'm done, you can add a lot more, up to 99. When you click OK, it's all going to be done. Click OK. Like you see there, it says the event. Bump, bump. Line break. If I want a line break. And I'm sending it to everybody. So like you see there, that's the only big difference there in the calendar. Actually, I thought you could do that already before, but hey, I guess this is something new. And that's it. This message now should be released, received by everybody. When they tap on it, they're going to see it right there. And when they tap here, it's just going to automatically add it to their calendar. That is it. That's the only difference there. That's what they mean with adding events to your own calendar and sharing your events with other people. Now, of course, the biggest change here, like you see here, is the theme of the icons and the background. And also, if you can see here clearly, the background music is also different. To change that, all you gotta do is go to settings. Now, when you go to settings, there's gonna be a section that says theme and background. When you tap there, you're gonna see here themes, start screen, and home screen background. Click there, and here you're gonna have all the themes available. These themes, you're gonna get it from the PSN store. That's where you're gonna get it. For example, if I wanna switch to this one, see there, bah, bah, bah. I like how it looks. It shows you a preview how the lock screen is gonna look and how the home pages are gonna be looking like, and the icons as well. So when you click select, it should apply it. Let's go ahead and see. It should apply it. Now we're done. If we go back here, look at that. Like you see there, the icons are very nice changed. Very cool. They look totally different. Of course, it doesn't change the icons of your games. Like you see, they stay the same. And the folders, they stay the same as well. Like you see there. But only the icons are the ones that changes. And the background music as well, which is awesome because the first background music was very, very annoying. Let's go ahead, turn this off. Let's go ahead, turn it on again, and look at that. That's how it looks. Of course, there's gonna be a lot more themes coming out in the PlayStation Store. There's gonna be a lot more themes coming out, so keep that in mind. There's gonna be themes from Uncharted, Tearaway, and all that. But of course, we're gonna have to wait for that. Here, when you go to Start Screen, you can either choose the theme that you're using. You could choose Go Default. That's how it look going default. Or you could choose an image right here. For example, let's say I want to choose that one, and it will automatically from right here change the theme of your lock screen. Now if I close the lock, open the phone, and now look at that. That's how it looks. That's normal, that's nothing new. But when you tap here, like you see, it changes the location of the clock as well and the date as well. You click there, click back, and there you go. Very cute. And basically that's it. You go here to home screen as well. If you go to edit mode, it will automatically change here everything to edit, which is very cool. Another thing that I noticed here is that now when you click here, you're gonna see a little bit more information. Like for example, intellectual property notices, that was if I'm not mistaken, that was not there before. You couldn't see that before. Now you can. Like you see there, go to a game here. So you see you have more information there. Of course, you can see the updates and all that given to the app. And that's it. Make sure you turn on the music, because if you turned it off like me, because I turned the music a long time ago off, because I was getting annoyed by the background sound, so I turned it off. So make sure you turn it on, because every time you apply a new theme, the background music or sound is going to be totally different. So make sure you do that. I'm going to stay with this one because it actually looks very nice. We got the themes. We got the sharing events with other friends via message and via email. And now we got in the trophy section, we have the option to see the rarity of the trophies. And that's it, guys. Let me know if you guys like this update or not. Are you happy with the changing themes here on the icons? Honestly, I just wish they just eliminated these bubbles. Honestly, I'm a little bit tired already of the bouncing bubbles already. It would have been nice if they brought the PlayStation 4 user interface here on the PlayStation Vita. It would have been very, very awesome. So I'd rather have that than the bubbles, because I'm a little bit tired with the bubbles. But hey, now you can customize the background music and the icons of the default apps. So guys, that's it. This was a look at the latest update 3.30 for the PlayStation Vita. See you next time, guys.